Hi, good morning guys. It's Jess and I have promised you on a few different occasions a pizza dough tutorial. Every time I post pictures of our family pizza night on Facebook or on the blog, it gets a lot of feedback with people saying, can you post a recipe? And I thought, you know, I'm just gonna make a tutorial for how I make my dough. It's super simple. It's about four ingredients. You can give or take a few ingredients, but really it's so simple. And you know, this recipe derived out of us moving out to rural Tennessee and not having any options when it comes to pizza delivery outside of the gas station. So for a foodie like myself and for somebody who absolutely adores pizza with every ounce of my being, I needed to come up with a way to make a good pizza. So we're going to begin here. It's pretty easy. Yeast, just 1.5 teaspoons. Put in your mixer, or you can stir it by hand as well. Salt. We have to do Himalayan salt, or this is just a good quality kosher salt. 1.5 teaspoons as well. And then bread flour. And I buy, I don't know how great you can see this. I buy Great River organic bread flour on Amazon, 25-pound bags. Because we go through a ton of flour, and really the ingredients make all the difference in this dough. And making this video is kind of twofold. They actually have a competition going on right now where they're looking for recipes using their flour, and the winning person will win a year's supply of flour. So I love this flour and I use it all the time, and I would love a year's supply of flour. Any little bit helps with 8 kids. So anyway, we start by adding about 4, 4.5 cups. And just add it right to the mixer here. And I apologize, this is obviously a very low budget film that we have going on here. It's just my laptop and me. So 4.5 cups to begin. So we have 1.5 teaspoons yeast, 1.5 teaspoons salt, about 4, 4.5 cups of flour. Let's mix that up for a couple minutes. Then I'm going to go get some water. We're going to start with 2 cups of water, and it doesn't have to be warm, it can be cold. And just pour that right in while it's mixing. Kind of let that all get mixed up a little bit. Keep an eye on it. And as it starts to come together, I don't know, 60 seconds or so, all right, so this is what you're after. It's all kind of sticking the mixer, and it's pretty wet right now, which is not how we want the finished product to be. So you're going to peel it off this, and then we're going to switch out the mixer paddle and put on our kneading paddle. So we're going to start kneading it, and it's too wet right now, so we're just going to slowly add some more flour until it starts to really come together nicely. And we're going to knead it for about 5 minutes or so. And I'm not going to make you sit and watch this entire process. We're going to turn that off. I made one ahead of time, just like they do on the professional shows. And this is how you want it to look. If you can see, when I stick my finger in it, it kind of bounces back. It's not so sticky that it's sticking to me anymore. And it doesn't stick to me at all. And you don't want it to get too dry either. You don't want to add too much flour. I would say overall probably 5.5 cups of flour total. And then we're just going to put it back in our well-greased bowl here. And I just let it rise all day long, until we're ready to roll it out and make pizzas at night. And between these two Doza ball that I'm making, it'll make about 8 12-inch pizzas. And that seems to be enough for our family. So, and people have asked whether you can use like whole wheat flour or multigrain flour, and you can use those flours. We've discovered that we like the white bread flour the best for the pizza crust. And then just to kind of amp up the health benefit a little bit, like this one has chia seeds in it. And this next one that I have going on will have fresh oregano in it. And that's just kind of how I justify using the white bread flour. So I hope that helps. And then, you know, of course, when you roll it out, get your oven as hot as you possibly can, about 500 degrees, and roll out your pizza dough and put your sauce and your toppings and everything, and then bake it for about 10 minutes. And enjoy. I hope that you can bring a little Ronnie pizza dough to your family. Thanks.